Prime Minister of Sri Lanka Mahinda Rajapakse is in New Delhi. A bilateral meeting with Prime Minister Narendra Modi focused a lot on many aspects to do with bilateral and regional, but the big thrust and focus was also the Tamils of Sri Lanka, the Tamil population, and what is it that the two countries can do to ensure that there is absolute reconciliation. I'm being joined by Mr. Anmugan Thondaman, who is the Minister for Resettlement. Many thanks for joining us, sir, here on India Today. Very important focus on the Tamil population of Sri Lanka. What was the discussion about when Prime Minister Narendra Modi met with his counterpart?
Basically, the whole discussion was centered on last November when our President Gotabaya Rajapaksa visited New Delhi. And he had discussions with the Prime Minister Narendra Modi. It was all centered around it. Basically, if you see about reconciliation, then about the one neighborhood, then it's about this terrorist acts, and then the fisheries part, then the housing, and other developments what India has been continuously doing in Sri Lanka. And at the same time, our Prime Minister thanked your Prime Minister and the government for all the support they have been giving so far and what they are going to do for us.
Minister, sir, were there any specifics when it comes to pledges? Were there any specific pledges? We know that there was a lot of thrust in development, economic development of the community and projects. But what are the specifics what India has pledged?
Specifics have to be worked out. Mm-hmm. It was only a broad-based discussion because it was just a continuation. I think, according to what they discussed, I think both parties will put their teams who will discuss the details.
Okay.
But more was on this the terrorism, how the regional both parties can get together and to safeguard the public in this region. And your Prime Minister mentioned it very clearly. One country, how powerful it is, or whatever technical they may be higher, they can't handle it. It has to be everybody has to
joint effort.
So that was very clear. And moreover, some of the developments which are going on as of now, like for example, if you take India has done housing for, if you take the Indian origins, India has been housing. So those ones they were very keen on. That whatever support they have been giving, to strengthen the defense, that was also discussed. And the Prime Minister also mentioned about reconciliation. He wanted the Sri Lankan government to come up with something adequate and quickly, so which I think our Prime Minister also agreed.
We'll focus on terrorism in a bit because Easter Sunday bombings were an eye-opener. It woke up not just Sri Lanka but the entire region on the big threat of terrorism in the region and the threat coming from Islamic State or ISIS as they call it. But coming back to resettlement, there have been concerns. India has shown a lot of concern with regards to the fact that there hasn't been the kind of resettlement and reconciliation that India would have hoped for Sri Lanka to have achieved by now and the implementation of the 19th Amendment.
Resettlement, of course, I feel, what India has given us more than 50,000 houses and all that, and there are other countries which have donated and all. But when I took over, what I could see was, why the delay? Either if we didn't have the funds or something, then we can say it over. But there is something else going on underneath. I feel this is purposely done to tarnish the name of the Sri Lankan government.
Done by whom?
Saying that they are not doing anything for the minorities. I felt that way when I took it over. So we will find a way to implement it as fast as possible.
But done by whom? Who do you think was responsible for the slow process?
Normally we are digging into it. Very soon we will have a reply for you. But I feel this is only to tarnish the name of the President or the Prime Minister and the government.
The complete inclusion, Minister Thondaman, has to be not just resettlement but also allowing empowerment. When it comes to empowerment and giving Tamils power, when will we see absolute empowerment?
See, before this, there were minorities in these positions. They should have pushed it across. Last 5 years, I don't think they pushed it. But today our president has a program where he wants us to expedite all that with empowerment and say a resettlement, which we are doing. You know, as you know, we took over only 2 months. By then we got the ministry settled, all that took some time. Then not the next month our general election is coming. So give us little time, we will sort out everything. Because even our prime minister was very clear today, whatever both sides are going to think, we must have a time frame within 6 months, we must do it. I feel that 6 months is a fair time for somebody. 5 years, nobody asked about this. But you can't ask two months immediately what happened.
In terms of the...
And one more thing.
Yes.
Like that,
yes, yes, sir.
That 5 years, now what I have, there were 3 ministers for that.
Hmm.
So now, there are some ministries who had 5 ministries under one person, 4 ministries, because we have reduced the ministers to 15.
Hmm.
So you'll have to give us that time.
Okay, so you've cut short the, you've made a smaller cabinet, but an important one with important positions.
But a bigger responsibility.
Responsibility. How hopeful are you? Because again, after the elections, there were, and once we saw the voting pattern, there were a lot of reports with regards to fears amongst the minorities, be it Tamils, the Muslim community, a lot of fear about or as to how the Rajapaksa regime is going to look at the minorities. What do you have to say about these fears?
You don't have to fear about anything.
Hmm.
As far as I'm concerned, if you're a Sri Lankan, there's no fear.
If you're a Sri Lankan, there's no fear. That's a very strong message coming
in. I'm a Sri Lankan. I'm a minority. I have no fear. And I am, out of the 2 minorities, I am 1 minority in the cabinet.
In terms of, again, there was a news report and a decision taken by the Sri Lankan government to do away with the national anthem being sung in Tamil language.
There was no decision like this.
Okay.
These are rumors. Now there's nothing to tarnish the president, the prime minister and the government. So opposition just... maybe one or two other outsiders would have said, there's no necessity. So, did the president say, no, I'm not going to put that there? Did you see any statement anywhere?
No. So, you're saying that national anthem in Tamil will be allowed?
Not will be allowed. How it was so many years, it will continue that way.
So, you're saying that the 2016 implementation of...
I'll tell you one thing.
In 2016, they allowed it. Singing of the national anthem.
Once.
Yes. Yes.
Yeah, if he didn't allow, they would have dropped the next day itself.
Most probably.
Now see, whatever has been happening from day one, it's normal.
So you're saying one country, one anthem.
No,
languages
see,
needn't
as far
be important.
As I'm concerned, we accept Sri Lanka as a Buddhist country.
Hmm.
Right? We are co-living with them.
Hmm.
And they respect our religion, we respect their religion. So what is the issue in this?
But you're okay with Tamils, which does not have to do with religion.
This
it has
was not an issue at all, no. You
it
must
wasn't.
Ask this question, who started this issue?
Okay. So you're saying that people who want to sing in Tamil would be okay?
No, people are singing, no, even now. In some schools they're singing, in some functions they're singing. Nobody came and said, stop it. So why are you making issues? If you have, the thing is they have nothing to mudsling.
Hmm.
Because after President Gotabaya Rajapaksa took over, he has cut down on expenses, he has done certain reforms, which common people are happy. Now, for example, he's promised the plantation workers, who I represent, 1,000 rupees wage increase with added attendance and productivity. Now, I was just told by the Secretary of Finance, sir, are you free on 13th? Can we discuss and sign the agreement?
Wow,
so,
that's important.
Things, yes, reform certain things under Prime Minister Mahinda Rajapaksa, things are falling in line. So there's nothing to tarnish the image of the government. So they say, they are saying they can't.
So you're saying that the minorities in Sri Lanka needn't fear the current regime and everything in terms of reconciliation and resettlement is also being looked into?
Not only minorities, nobody need to fear about the present thing. This is the safest government you can get.
Mr. Thondaman, there has been a very important legislation in India that called the Citizenship Amendment Act, which talks about minorities, persecuted minorities from 3 countries who'd get citizenship in India, Pakistan, Afghanistan and Bangladesh, but leaves out Sri Lanka, from where there have been a massive number of refugees living in India for years, How does the Tamil community look at this CAA?
First of all, it is an internal matter. First of all, India has to protect itself. Right? And I feel the relationship we have with India, I don't think we will face an issue. Right? So, people pulling Sri Lanka also into this is not necessary at all. I will be the outlook, how India looks at Sri Lanka is different from how it looks at the others. And as far as I'm concerned, first India has to look after itself before stretching a hand out. So that is my stand.
Also, does it look like CAA is a little exclusionary because it excludes one entire community, that's the Muslim community?
That is your internal matter. We cannot tell any, I cannot comment on your government's policy or thing because that is done for the best of India. So as far as I'm concerned, the relationship we Tamils have with the government of India is different from others. It is like your own kid and a stepmother's kid. So we are your own kid.
Okay.
So leave up. That is different, this is different.
Talking about safety, for Sri Lanka today, terrorism has become a major issue. We know that President Gotabaya Rajapakse was on the forefront of fighting the LTTE, and now we are seeing him take over as president at a time when we are looking at the Islamic State having some influence amongst a very minor section of the Sri Lankan population. What was the kind of cooperation that the two countries spoke about in the bilateral talks?
See, this was the April 21st, that's an unfortunate incident, was a total negligence because the Indian government had given information, given all necessary things, who's going to do, where is he, all that. Our people neglected it. The then government neglected it. Otherwise, we could have stopped this. So, before it happened in April, when the last government handed over, security was in place.
Yes.
This was a mere negligence of the last government. So today we are waiting for it. So now I feel under the presidency of Gotabaya Rajapakse, president, and Prime Minister Mahinda Rajapakse, we'll be safe again. Very, very safe again.
On the fishermen's issue, very specifically on the fishermen's issue, although we know that you have a colleague who's the Minister of Fisheries, but in terms of human beings, the fishermen cause and cause of fishermen.
Because the fishermen issue mainly today we discuss, they do that,
bottom trawling.
Trawling.
Yes.
That is very, that destroys
the fauna, flora of the.
So that is what we are saying, no. Earlier Sri Lankan fishermen used to do that. But now they have shifted to deep sea fishing. So today your Prime Minister said they are now allocated 7,000 crores or something to
change the ways of
for your fishermen to give them training, that this and equipments to do deep sea fishing. So now they have agreed they will study the papers, both countries to put one body authority where they will discuss and settle that issue. I think that will come to a settlement. In the meantime, Sri Lankan government has agreed to release the boats which are there. They have invited the owners of the boats to come and see their boats and they can. Some are in courts, which the courts will give the decision. And because last time when our president came, I think he gave his word that you can release. According to that, things are working out. Same way, there are about 24 or something, 26 boats here, Sri Lankan boats. I think the authorities here said they'll also do the. To release those.
Finally, before I let you go, the very important aspect of Indo-Pacific and how important Sri Lanka is in the region, everybody is looking at the Indian Ocean and strategically Sri Lanka is very important. India has always had historical ties with Sri Lanka, but there are now again some concerns with regards to other countries having influence in Sri Lanka. That's a concern that India has raised many a times, particularly with Chinese presence in
taken up, and that was they have decided within very soon they'll be signing the agreement
on maritime agreement. But in terms of concerns with regards to China,
no, that both parties have discussed. This was just over the table.
Okay.
Maybe next time I come, I'll be able to give you more light on that.
Okay, and finally, the Sri Lanka being a part of the blue economy, Indian Ocean, very important. How do you look at the larger concept of what the United States of America, India are now proposing, the Indo-Pacific, and Sri Lanka's role in that region, in that region?
As far as I'm concerned, I have not studied that or anything, but I feel as bigger brother, Sri Lanka's interest will be looked after by India.
On
that,
all right,
we have to coexist.
Because Jaffna is again, you know, the entire area is very important and
no,
coastal area.
As long as we two are together, nothing will happen to both our countries.
Is that a message that comes from India as well for Sri Lanka?
Surely that. We don't know. People in India are very good. They look after us.
On that note, many thanks for joining us. The Minister of Resettlement of Sri Lanka speaking exclusively to India Today. The message very strong that Sri Lanka's interests will be looked after if both India and Sri Lanka are on the same page.